We're talking about 15 proofs that we're living in not just the last days, but in the final second before the soon coming day of the Lord, CERN. Who's ever heard of CERN? All right, all right. Well, praise the Lord. Hey, so what's CERN, right? The European Organization for Nuclear Research, known as CERN, is a European research organization that operates the largest particle physics laboratory in the world. The Large Hadron Collider at CERN is a particle booster built to beam up protons in very high speed in opposite directions until they collide, creating a huge amount of energy capable to reproduce similar cosmic conditions that have created, and I quote, such phenomena such as dark matter, antimatter, and ultimately the creation of the universe billions of years ago. And has also been rumored to be a device that can bend space, open dimensions, such as portals. CERN is a massive scientific instrument that was in fact designed to be a Stargate or a Saturn machine. Am I getting too deep with you guys? Is this all right? Yeah, it is. Wow. Amen to that, sister. A Saturn machine is a space-time machine. People are like, come on, evangelist. Now you've gone off the deep end. What is this, Back to the Future? Michael J. Fox? We're talking about Doc? What is this all about? Let's check it out. This has the intention of opening up interdimensional portals, and CERN is located in Geneva, Switzerland. By the way, the same Switzerland that had the longest, deepest tunnel / abyss where they did that satanic ceremony. Located in Geneva, Switzerland, Geneva and Saint Genise are similar to the word Genesis. The purpose of CERN is to find the origins of man and the universe. The problem? They're doing this outside of God. They have stated that they want to open a doorway to another dimension and find a God. They want to find a God. Is it just a coincidence that CERN is short for the horned god Cernonus? Is it also a coincidence that CERN has to go deep underground to do their god-harnessing experiments? Cernonus was the god of the underworld. CERN is linked to several secret projects carried out by the European Union and the European Trilateral Commission. CERN is also responsible for the internet and having been doing ongoing research for governments with regard to global sustainability. It was also reported that in 1999, CERN proposed and carried out a quantum vortex experiment searching for solar axions. Axions are hypothetical particles that are components of what's called dark matter. You may say, what does this matter to me? This is going into another dimension. You're messing with God and you're messing with demons in this case. That's why it matters. And this closely relates to the book of Revelation when it talks about the trumpets and how locusts will come out of the abyss. The abyss is that dark matter. These people are serious. This has gone beyond mad scientific research. They're seriously seeking. They're trying to open up the door to Satan. Spiritually and physically. In order to find these axions, CERN proposed the use of a decommissioned magnet called Satan. That's crazy stuff. What? You're going to be that obvious? Well, yeah, it's like the Vatican looking for aliens, right? In their global research center with the telescope by the name of Lucifer. You went there, evangelist? Yes. All this is documented facts. It was an acronym. The Satan was an acronym for Solar Axion Telescopic Antenna. One of the attempts at creating a portal anchor happened in an area where this is rumored to be an ancient stargate in what many believe to be the real ancient Babylon, Iraq. Oh, everything's spiritual. It's all biblical. It's all biblical. Even a top physicist at CERN admitted, and I quote, something may come through dimensional doors at the Large Hadron Collider. And out of this door might come something, or we might send something through it. What are they doing? This is according to Sergio Bertolucci, Director for Research and Scientific Computing at CERN. So many say, oh, CERN's not a big deal. Check it out. They're not only trying to recreate the Big Bang, they're trying to figure out what's the glue that holds the universe together. And at the same time, they admit that they may cause the layer around the Earth. You ever seen the layer around the Earth, maybe through scientific image? It looks like a light covering. That's the glory of God. I know we get all scientific, seven layers of atmospheres and all that. No, we're not. But I'm saying very specifically, that's the glory of God. God knows how he did this planet. And you have the enemy working overtime to punch a hole through that, because they say that that glory will literally minimize with the Large Hadron Collider going at the speed that it's going. It's beyond the speed of light. The CERN logo is very interesting. It's plainly 666. That's the mark of the beast. Oh, Anita, you're trying to look for a devil around every bush. Stop it already. Why can't it just be the way it is? Why do you got to do it? No, I'm not doing it. I'm breaking it down. It's plainly in sight. They're doing this in our face. They're saying, ha, stupid. Look what we're about to do. We're about to get our God on the earth. Get ready. This is for the devil. This is for the arrival of the Antichrist. They're creating an atmosphere. You know, okay, we're Christians. We create an atmosphere for the presence of God, right? When we worship the Lord. We sing praises to his name. Play some beautiful worship music. We pray in the spirit. We just start to talk to the Lord. That creates an atmosphere. Say, Father, you're welcome in this place. The Lord is here in this room. He's ministering to each and every one of us. For those that are waiting for the arrival of the beast, they're creating an atmosphere for the arrival of Satan. That's number three. Number three. Did I miss something here? Hold on. Okay. No, I'm missing something here. Oh, okay. No, we're still here. Okay. The next one. Time does not allow me to tell you all the other ways the world is crying out for the unveiling of the beast, the Antichrist. Satanic temple unveiling 7-foot goat head Baphomet statue over in Oklahoma Capitol. What happened to the Ten Commandments? Now you're gonna display the devil? Human microchips in our future. Talking about that Mark of the Beast type technology. Mark of the Beast is going to be more than computerized, but it will, make no mistake about it, include technology. Knowledge will increase, the Bible says, in the last days, according to the book of Daniel. Satanic children's big book and color activities. Fox News mainstream media picked this up because they were stunned. Color between the horns. Satanic group wants coloring book in schools. Your baby schools. This went out through all of Florida. The Satanic Temple said, wait a minute, because it was a Bible organization, a nonprofit Christian organization that said, we have the right to pass out Bibles in public school. And they were confirmed that right by the court. So you had now Satanists from the High Satanic Temple stating, if you're going to do that, we're going to do our own evangelizing. And this was available at every public school in Florida. Satanic statue unveiling over in Detroit, Michigan. People are in line here. You guys came in to hear the word. These people came in. They're in line to do a high satanic spiritual worship unto the beast. They were there to celebrate this statue unveiling. Time seriously does not allow me all the continued proofs that people are vying for the beast. This is an Illuminati triangle hand sign showcasing that he's down for the global unity. He's down for the Antichrist beat system. Madonna literally knows what she's doing, and she looks like a Baphomet and even performs as one in honor to the beast. There are many who have listened to these famous artists, singers, George Soros, right, the globalist himself, given a hand sign to make sure the beast still continues giving him his millions or billions, right? What is it to a man if you gain the whole world and lose your soul? All these people have gained all the world, right? The glory, the riches, the honor, the fame, but they've lost their soul. As long as they're breathing, they can repent. And we pray for them to repent. We really do. We here at Open Your Eyes People have and will continue to pray for these people to repent. Now they have shirts showcasing your solidarity with the beast. Illuminati, meaning enlightened one. Now you can showcase that you want to be enlightened, not by the Lord Jesus Christ, who is the light of the world, but by the false bearer of light, Satan. This is all over the place. I refuse to have on my website. Yeah, people saying, evangelist, you have one of those, the mark of the beast type? You will not see me have it on any of our CDs, on any of our websites. Oh, but it's easier to access. I don't care. I refuse, because that's what you see. Now, if you happen to have it, I'm not knocking you. Okay, we got business owners who are tuning in. You got that, But I'm just giving you all a heads up. They're infiltrating things. You know, we run a Christian ministry. I will not have it. It's weird when I see a church have this. RFID, anybody? Right hand swipe. He will cause all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and slave, to take a mark on their right hand or on their forehead so that no man will be able to buy or sell. Let's say have the mark of the beast or the image of his name. Now, these little wristbands obviously are not the mark of the beast, but it's conditioning the mind to swipe the right hand for the time of the beast. Eight on Your Side did an interview that stunned many, talking about microchipping your kids. You want to know where your kids are at, right? Just in case they get kidnapped or lost, now you can go shopping in peace. So when you go to the mall, they could be three stores down, five-year-old Johnny, just come meet me, and if I don't find you, I'll know where to locate you. I put a microchip in you, like they're a dog. They started with the animals, poor things. But the convenience, right? There's always a benefit to selling your soul. Come on. I went there. We got some kids in the house outside of mine. I know I got some precious babies. Don't get mad at the preacher. SpongeBob got the triangle, got all one-eyed out. He's worse. He's getting the kids conditioned. He's not the only one. Kids at schools now have palm scan readers to get lunch. What happened to the little punchy hole things? What happened? They got crazy. Why you got to scan the kid's hand to get lunches from Michelle Obama? One little fish stick, come on. She's not even feeding the kids right. You know, go through that. That lunch lady, you know she's lying. She's all... Oh, man, this is a mess. The mark of the beast type technology and conditioning of the mind here that we're looking at. SmartGate, now they have student ID cards with automatic SMS facility. They're not hiding this thing. It's in our face. Wow.